Hey there, folks, and welcome back to Space Engineers. Last episode, I asked you guys if we should put on the new cargo ships, and you guys answered with a resounding yes. So we're going to do that, but first, before we do that, we are going to have to build a reconnaissance scout ship so that we can fly out, dock, and then bring it back. So, I have been busy off camera, mining and refining parts, and we have some stuff in there, but the important stuff that we need are the thrust components. We'll take a couple of those. Well, actually, we'll save those. We need the steel plates, and some other stuff. Probably a little bit later, we're going to be putting guns on our scout craft, but I don't think we're going to do that right now. So, let's see. Let's go into our crafting menu, see what blocks we need. I'm going to actually make them out of heavy armor, because if we put guns on it, it'll be a little fighter craft, and heavy armor is good for that. We will need a cockpit, some small thrusters, a gyroscope, a small reactor, those parts. See, what other parts are we missing that we need? Well, we'll put those on later. Yeah, we'll probably need these too. And some landing gear. Alright, so let us make a new small craft. Let's go out here a little bit, away from the gravity. Not that I think it really matters, but we'll build our ship out here. Whoops. And let's do new small ship. I guess this is the way it's going to be. Oh, I need construction components. Well, I better go get that. So we'll get some construction components as well. We'll probably grab a couple thrust components too, because we're going to need that to start off the engines. So we'll drag and say, whoops. We'll bring back 80 of those, and then we'll take 20 of those and some thrust components. Good enough. 20 of those, it looks like. Alright. Turn our jetpack on and we'll start flying out here. And there we go. New small ship. Ah, that's what I'm looking for. Let's see here. We're going to rotate this. There we go. We're going to want to place heavy armor block there, one there, and one on the other side to make it symmetrical. I could build this using the symmetry tool, but it's not going to be that big of a ship, so we really don't need to. So where are we going to put our cockpit? I need interior panels for that. Well, anyhow, let's finish building the base for this. Gotta make sure we don't bump into it, otherwise it'll fly off into space. It doesn't have any engines or anything yet. Alright. I'm gonna put the engine, or the reactors. Face this. We're gonna wanna face them down so we can access them. Whoop, didn't mean to press that. We'll probably need three reactors for this, because I'm planning on putting a bunch of engines on this. It's going to be our scout craft. And then we're going to just finish it off like that. Well, not like that. And we're also going to put some more landing gear on this. And we're going to rotate it like that. There we go. Let's see. Put that one there. What do we need for the Oh, we need large steel tubes for these. Alright, well, I suppose we better get the large steel tubes and some interior plate as well. So, how many of these can we bring with us? Only one? Well, they are pretty heavy. Any interior plates? Well, we can bring a couple of those. And I guess we don't need thrust components right away. We'll just bring as many steel tubes as we can then. And I gotta make sure not to bump this. I keep telling myself that because I know I inevitably will accidentally bump this and it's gonna go flying off. There we go. Looking good. Now we need some for the lateral thrust. And rotate it this way. Oh, of course I need more small steel tubes. But this we will place. Eh, that's good enough. Now we need to place a couple gyroscopes. Gotta place that one, come on. There we go. Two gyroscopes should be good. It's not gonna be that heavy of a craft. And now to get some more steel tubes. Well, actually, let's finish building the shape of the craft first. There we go. Oops. I want this, and then we're going to rotate it. There we go, that's the way I wanted to rotate it. And then we're going to rotate this again. There we go. Place one more on the nose. Oh, not there. Yep, there. And rotate it again. There we go. So that'll be the front of the craft. Just acts as a little bumper in case we run into anything. And there we have our engines. We're going to have some lateral engines going that way, some going on top and on the bottom, and we're going to have some retro thrusters as well. And we might even throw a cargo container on there for good measure. Because you never know when you need to haul something. Alright, now let's get some more small steel tubes. Seven of those. Alrighty then. And now let's make some more thrusters. Let's put those there. I have two going in that direction. I want two going in the opposite direction. There we go. And then we're going to want to... Whoops, not that. There we go. Two going like that. And now we need two retro thrusters. Now where are we going to put the retro thrusters? How about right on the side underneath? There we go. Oh, I probably ran out of steel tubes again, didn't I? Yep. One thing about this realistic mode is you really can't carry much in your inventory. Alright, let's grab some more small steel tubes. Large steel tubes, I'm sorry. Come on. There we go. Don't need that on us right now. Maybe we can bring another one? Nope. Maybe if I take all of these out, we can bring another one. There we go. Alright, so we're gonna place that thruster there. Now we need two final thrusters that going in the down Y direction. And we'll rotate these. Eventually we'll get it right. There we go. And now all we need to do is finish all of the rest of these parts. And I think I'm going to finish this in a time lapse so you don't have to watch me go back and forth, because it's going to take probably a good 15 minutes to half an hour to actually finish this. But we'll meet back with you guys when we are done. Alright, see you guys in a bit. Alright folks, and we're back! So, here it is, the finished product. We have three landing gears so that hopefully they will actually lock on when we're approaching the cargo ship. Because the idea is the cargo ship's going to be flying by at a pretty quick rate, and we're going to want to have to catch up with our new little scout craft, and then we're going to dock and lock our landing gear on it. And then from there, we'll get in the cockpit and hijack it, I guess you could say. I'm not sure what to expect, so I'm going to take a gun just in case. And we do have a gun back at our mining base. So I best grab that. And this craft is a lot more maneuverable and quick than our little mining craft down there, so that's always nice as well. So one thing we probably could or should do is make a little landing deck for our fleet of ships. Because soon enough we're gonna have a lot of these little craft flying around and no place to dock them all. Here, we're gonna lock the gear, get out, turn off our jetpack, and there we go. We have quite a few rockets on this, and it requires 3 generators to keep it powered. Ow. Apparently if you walk in front of these, that hurts. Hmm. Or maybe Space Jesus. Yes, you. Keep on trying to kill us. Alright, so I guess now the thing to do would be to turn on the cargo ship. So I suppose we should do that. Alright, here we are. We're in the settings. We're going to turn on the cargo ships. One thing that I think I mentioned before is that they have added like meteor storms, and right now we just have it on safe because that's default. But if you guys want me to turn on the meteor storms, we can have it on normal, cataclysmic, or Armageddon. Hopefully not Armageddon, but essentially what the meteor storms do is they throw little balls of rocks at pretty much everything, and if your ships or base is in the way of the meteor, yeah, it pretty much will destroy it. Or put a nice big hole in it. So if you guys want me to turn that on or turn it on for an episode or something, just tell me and I'll do that. But turned on the cargo ship, so there's that. Meet you back in the real world. Alright, and we're back, and right away, as you can see, there is a mining transport 14 kilometers away. So let's jump in our scout craft that we just built and see if we can catch up with it. Dock it. Oh, I forgot to grab my gun. I'm gonna have to quick grab my gun, and then we're going to dock it, dock with it, and hopefully hijack and bring it back to our base to either part out, use, or something. So here we go. We'll grab the gun. We'll grab one magazine. Should be fine. Let's drag that in our hotbar. There we go. Alright, there's a gun. Let's go. I don't know which way it's going, and hopefully we can catch up with it. Let's undock, and is it getting closer or further away? It's getting closer, so that's good, but let's dock with that thing. Full speed ahead. Looks like we are at max speed. Turn our inertial dampeners off and let's drift all the way to the target. From my understanding, there are several different varieties of the mining transport that spawn in, so I guess we'll see which one we got. I'm getting closer, only 10 kilometers away now. We're putting a big distance between us and our mining base. That's kind of why I wanted to bring this craft and dock with it, because I'm pretty sure if I left my ship that I'm in right now, I probably would never find it again unless I put a beacon on it. Okay, we're only 7 kilometers away now, and we're approaching quickly. So we're about a minute away from the target. Not mistaken. You can't see it yet, so it's gotta be pretty small. Whoosh. Do a little spin for fun. And as you can see, we have plenty of fuel. 31 years worth of fuel if I'm just drifting like this. Oh, it's coming into view. I'm gonna turn on our inertial dampeners pretty soon. Oh, I know what I forgot to do. I forgot to bring more uranium, because I don't know if that's going to have enough uranium to make it back to the mining base. Let's see here. Which one is it? Getting closer, getting closer. Hmm. Interesting. Interesting indeed. Let's see how quick this thing is moving. Huh. It looks like there's an engine out on that thing. It's moving at a pretty decent clip. I have to find where the entrance is. Where is the pilot thing? This is going to be a bit tricky. Oh, we're in proximity. I think we locked. Now let's see. Yeah, there we go. We're on it. Let's see here. Now where, oh where, is the piloting chair? Interesting. This would certainly be useful. Ah, there it is. Oh, no. It's getting away from us. Turn our inertial dampeners. Whoa. This is going to be a bit tricky. Uh-oh. Don't want to hit this too hard, otherwise I'll hurt myself. Ow. Well, interesting. Oh. Yeah, it's actually a little bit easier to fly with the inertial dampeners off, so I'm going to do that. So we'll just zero our velocity with this craft. Oh, almost there, almost there, almost there. Oh. Oh, there's a turret in there. Just to make sure it doesn't shoot at us. I don't know, it might. Okay, well, let's turn our jetpack back on. We're gonna close the door. Turn our jetpack. Oh. There we go. Come on. And there we go. Inertial dampeners on. Whew. That was an ordeal and a half. Now let's see here. Mining base that way. So let's bring this big behemoth back to our base with us. I'm gonna have to take a look at it and see what's all there. So, let's take a look around. It looks like there's two machine guns. There are two docking gear on that side. Interesting. This is a very interesting design, and those are all conveyors. And it looks like there's two large cargo containers right there. And you can see where we docked, right there. There's a number of engines facing in every direction. It looks like, I wonder what that little piece is right there. Oh, I bet you that's an unfinished ore detector. It also looks like, I thought I saw a refinery on here somewhere. No, maybe not. Oh yeah, there's two refineries there. So, that'll be cool. We'll be able to start exploring the other asteroids. This doesn't have a gravity generator on it, I don't think. So we're gonna have to put a gravity generator on it. We'll be able to finish this, probably no problem. Alright, let me hop out of the seat here. Okay, so there's a gravity generator. Let me turn that thing on. Whoop. There we go. Ah. So here we have a cargo container. Let's see what's in it. Ooh, yes. Got plenty of uranium. Got some silver there as well. We also have some magnesium, we have some gold, and some cobalt. Cool. Let's see, how much uranium do we have in here? Not too terribly much, but we don't really need that much to get back to our base. Make sure we're not going to run into anything. Yeah, we're still 8 kilometers away. Gonna speed up a little bit. It's not the fastest ship in the verse, but we can fix that with a couple of rockets. Also, it looks like that rocket up there is a little bit damaged, or just incomplete. So, let's get out of here. Let's turn off our jetpack, and let's actually see what's all on the ship that we can't see. So we have 2 Gatling turrets, 1 gravity generator, 3 gyroscopes. Well, one is, or 4 gyroscopes, one is incomplete. What is that? That's just the command can control section. So we have a whole bunch of thrusters, one of which is incomplete, one of the refineries is incomplete, the ore detector is incomplete, and that's that weird circular looking thing. We have a spot, or 2 spotlights. Okay, so that's pretty cool. That is cool. And I'm pretty sure I probably damaged this by shooting at it, but it doesn't look like... Let's see here. Maybe if I bring out my handy-dandy welder, I'll see how damaged it actually is. Yeah. There we go. All fixed. So this... The refinery needs pretty much everything, except for 905 steel plates. This is a little bit damaged, so I don't think anything else. The beacon is in good shape. Gravity generator in good shape. Both reactors in good shape. The cockpit's in good shape. Let me hop back in here, see how close we are. Okay, we're closing in. And our scout craft is docked nicely on the underside of this. Hmm. It's interesting. I wonder what those 2 things on those... The little black ovals are for. Maybe that's just a little pad. Huh. So that's where we entered. I wonder what all these conveyors are for. They obviously move... Oh, I bet you I know what... People work on these decks, and then they throw the stuff in the conveyors, and then the conveyors throw it in these big cargo containers. Ah, that's probably what it is. Oh, and there's our base coming into view. Let's, turn our inertial dampeners back on. I'm gonna have to make a nice big landing pad for this thing. This thing's probably bigger than our entire base is. Alright. Less than a kilometer away now, and there we see it. There's our base. Now let's dock. Nope, I'm getting further away. I don't want to get further away. I want to get closer. There we go. This thing has a lot of mass to it. I'm going to have to add some more rockets to it to make it a little more maneuverable. Yeah, slowly but surely, it's like trying to move an oil tanker into position. Don't crash. Don't crash. No pressure. There we go. There we go. Our scout ship is hanging on, so that's good. I was afraid that if we do too many fast maneuvers, well, this thing can't really do fast maneuvers, but if I did, we would lose our scout craft on the bottom of there, but we seem to be doing fine. Yep. We're burning down a little bit. There we go. There we go. Almost there. Stay on target. Uh-oh. There we go. We got this. We got this. Let's make sure we're not going to run into anything. think we're good so far. Less than 100 meters away. There we go. Well, I'm not going to actually dock it with our station because it's, there's really no point. We'll have to make a little docking pad for this thing. We'll have to finish it, too. Alright. So there we go. Let me just get out of here. Oh, maybe rotate it a bit so that the gravity fields are in sync. There we go. Isn't that a beauty? Got 6 days worth of fuel if we just let it idle here. So, that'll be fine for now. I'm actually going to turn the gravity generator off. Because it's messing with the gravity field that's already there. There we go. Turn off our jetpack. Well, we'll have to finish this too. Alright. Turn on our jetpack. And out we go. I suppose I should move our scout craft back into our mining base. Go undock. Oh, there we go. Do a little bit of a flip, and we'll fly back up here. Yeah, I want our inertial dampeners on now, and we'll dock at our mining base. Go, rotate that, see if we can get all three landed. There we go. We'll turn the landing gear on. Oh, whoop, that's weird. It looks like I landed that a bit hard and dented the surface of our wonderful mining base. Eh. All better. Well, not quite actually. Like brand new. There we go. Now isn't that awesome? I've never actually seen that particular mining transport before. Well, that's cool. So we've added quite a bit to our collection today. We've got a new scout craft and we've got a massive old mining transport. We'll probably have to fix that up next episode and get that running. We'll probably take that over to a different asteroid, because this is our mining base for this asteroid, and that's actually would make a nice mobile mining base for another one. So, that's actually going to be it for this episode. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you folks next time.